Bruce is receiving chest compressions, but there's no need to worry about his medical condition.
This is one of our mannequins here at Sims. Bruce, he can breathe, he has breast sounds, heart sounds, bowel sounds.
We have the ability with Bruce to start an intravenous. If there's a medication we need to give Bruce, there's barcode sensors in it that detect what that medication is. The sensors in the IV tubing detect how much we gave, and the mannequin has the ability to instantly respond according to our actions, similar to a real life patient.
The Saskatoon Institute for Medical Simulation, or SIMS, is the first privately owned medical simulation center in Saskatchewan, offering continuing education to those in the field.
Jan and I felt there was a real gap in that practicing healthcare teams, physicians, nurses, paramedics, weren't able to practice in this manner.
Very important to really emphasize that the healthcare teams need that ongoing continuing medical education to stay sharp, because medicine is evolving all the time.
SIMS offers training across the province using dummies like Bruce and this baby to improve skills and communication among healthcare professionals.
Whether it's a student, whether it's a physician, a nurse, a paramedic, it's really important to create a safe learning environment for the students so they can practice on this mannequin before they go out into the real world and practice on a real patient.
The duo says medical errors claim the lives of approximately 28,000 Canadians each year. Their goal with SIMS is to reduce that statistic.
We had a session where we were doing some training for some VPs in the Saskatoon Health Region, and one in particular said that this is the most incredible learning experience.
We've had physicians, nurses, paramedics in here that said it's the best education they've had, being able to practice and actually do it in a real life setting.
To see a list of courses offered through SIMS, visit sasksims.ca. For Go Saskatoon, I'm Liz Pittman.